Hi.
Welcome to the Gunner's Vault. A lot of people will tell you, don't try this at home. Me? I'm going to tell you, as long as you're legal and not stupid, yeah, try it at home.
Okay, well, we're here at the shop early in the morning. You know, it's Tuesday, I think. I'm here before everybody else. It's kind of what I do. I'm an insomniac, so I come in early a lot. I want to go over a couple things with y'all. You know, I kind of make gunsmithing look like, you know, people come in and bring machine guns all the time, or all I do is machine guns. I do actually work on a lot of machine guns. That's kind of my niche, which is cool. But a lot of the time, I'm just doing regular stuff, you know. I'm just Remington Model 1100. I'm going to show y'all what working on these is like here in a little bit. But, well, you kind of get the idea. You know, so there's not a lot of glory in this job. I lucked into the whole TV thing. But, you know, other than that, yeah. And the TV thing's like, meh. You know, it was fun. Yeah, whatever. Look, there's Ryan. Say hi, Ryan.
Oh, what's going on?
Nah. You're on internet YouTube, right?
Oh, cool. Hey, how's it going, guys?
What are you working on?
That's the 1911 project.
Oh, okay. See, Ryan's working on a 1911. Not a machine gun. You know, we work on them sometimes, not all the time. Another thing, I go over, you know, like M249s and stuff like that, and I'll say, man, these are great weapons. They are. They're fun to play with when I'm out at the range. Taking it out in the field, doing it for real, I have no clue how the M249 works. It might work great, might suck. Initially, I understand they sucked. For me, who can go home and clean it every night, it's a great weapon. For, you know, Staff Sergeant whoever, who has to go out and use it every day and doesn't have the luxury of cleaning it or taking care of it or whatever, you know, that weapon might not be the greatest. And that's true with a lot of the weapons that we've play with, you know, PPSH-41, PPS-43, MG-42, MG-34. I'll say, yeah, they're great weapons, and they are when I'm at the range using them, and I have tools and I can fix them or whatever. When I'm out in the, well, when somebody's out in the field using this for real, they're gonna have a whole different opinion of the MG-34 than I do. Remember, all of my combat experiences is flying around in a helicopter, getting shot at and shooting back and blah 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 blah. So, the guys on the ground, and if I was on the ground, yeah, I'm probably going to panic. I don't know. I got some training, but you know, I ain't never been there. You never know till you are.
I did it first.
Yeah, Ryan did. Yeah, Ryan was a ground guy. Now he's an intel guy. It's weird. Share some secrets. He can't. I can't either. I know things. I'm special like that. So yeah, I'm going to show y'all working on 1100, and like 5 minutes into this, you're going to be bored and want to blow your brains out. All right, check it out. All right, so this is Remington 1100 12 gauge shotgun. This is a little crap 22 I got to work on after the 1100. Look, this is the kind of stuff you get. It's an old H&R 22. Ooh, beautiful, ain't it? The hand is messed up on it, so I'm going to have to build a new hand or add on to that one. The hand is a little thing that catches the spurs in the back of the cylinder and allows the cylinder to revolve. But anyway, Remington 1100, we got it in from the owner, and he basically said, does not feed or eject, does not take more than two shells. Well, that doesn't really tell you a lot, so I put it on the test fire rack to test fire it and see what was up with it. And yeah, it didn't feed. Well, it fed, actually, by hand. It cycled. Well, yeah. All right, let me backtrack. It fed right initially, but it didn't eject, it didn't extract, and it didn't cycle. So I checked the gas system was screwed up a little bit. I rearranged the gas piston, that's the problem the dude had, and it still wasn't working right. So we've got another problem. It's already been checked for safe, so I know it is. It's clear and all that. So I'm thinking this dude's got a real problem with his gas system, but I don't know where. Something in the recoil assembly, maybe. I don't know. I have to just take it apart and, you know, go a little more in depth than I did before. Take these out. Sometimes they're easy. Sometimes you need a little hammer on the end of your punch for them. This time it's easy. Kind of lucked out with that. All right, now you got the shell latches right here. Once you got to press in, pull out the bolt and the carrier. Look inside the receiver, make sure there's no obvious screwed up things in it. Recoil doesn't seem bad at all. Alright, so we'll leave the link in there for right now. We'll mess with it a little later. We're just going to inspect everything, make sure everything looks cool. Might as well sit down while I'm doing this. I have a feeling I'm going to be messing with this for a while. Nothing obvious. What is that? Somebody's been at this gun with a grinder. Aha. Yeah. Check this out. Normally I'd leave these over there and just go through them over there, but I'm filming, so I want y'all to have the complete gunsmithing experience. That was my text message, by the way. So what we do is go through our parts, our 1100 Remington parts, and look for this. That's what we need. Need that, 1187 and 1100 are about the same. Piston seal. O-ring. All right, now check it out. We take our piston seal. And then we take our, what is this thing called? The piston. Put these together. So what they got on this thing is the entirely wrong thing here. There you go. That's your newfangled piston. This is an old setup. Two piece, it's pretty old. Their O-ring's kind of screwed up too. So.
Hey, what's up, man?
We're going to go ahead and put all this stuff back up. Minus the piston, which I have right here. Or not the piston, the O-ring, which I have right here. I'll be right back. I got a text message. Okay. I got a friend of mine here, and it's time to open. So basically what I'm going to do is swap out this old piston parts for this new piston, new O-ring. Should work fine. Easy fix. I should have caught the old piston stuff in the first place, but I didn't because it was late yesterday and I was tired. But anyway, should be an easy fix. Okay, here's some more gunsmithing stuff that we do. This is called a hand. It's the little thing, the little spur that pushes up your cylinder into place. This one was wore off, so I welded on a little BB of metal. Little tiny BB. And what I'm going to do now is grind it flat. Then I'm going to use my various files to shape it into what I need. And you'll get to see it live in action. So I don't want to go too much. I just want to get the bulk of it off. There's a little angle to it, so I'll put that in there too. Yeah. Now the fun part. I get to file it for like the next hour. Yes, I know, files only work one direction. Got a little more abrasive first. Alright, I'm almost flush, so now I get something. This is my all-purpose homemade vise. It has smooth jaws, so it's not going to put little divots in anything. You'll notice the tunes in the background. Yeah. Come on. It's a neat little vise. Homemade gig. Works pretty well. See, I want it to go this way though. And there's no real good way to put this flat, otherwise I'd put this flat. But like I said, there's no real way to do that. No real good way anyway. So what we're gonna do is put it standing up. It's not ideal, but it'll work. I know, files only work one direction. It's just easier to do it this way. Alright, so we're there on that. We've got it nice and flush with the edge. So now we have to mimic this angle right here. Got so far. It's basically, you know, nice and flat. There is a little bevel which I had to make on it, and a little point that it comes to. That's no big deal. So I'll start doing that now. The part of this is rounded, so that means we took the rounded file. Looking for?
I forgot to sign this out yesterday.
Oh. Take off most of it first. It's moving. So I have to re-attack in the vise, put it a different way. Bet you it won't move now. create a little bevel. This is gonna be the hard part. And there's my little piece. Back to somewhat factory specs. It's going to be too long, but I won't know exactly how long it needs to be until I put it in there and try it. That's pretty basic. That's easy. So let me go polish this up a little bit. I'm going to see if I can focus on this thing. Focus, damn you. There we go. Ah, the heart. There we go. After time, you build up a pretty cool slave pin collection. Here's mine. Haven't had a chance to use this one yet. You're like, what do you use a slave pin for? I know, you're like, what do you use a slave pin for? Well, I'll show you. See if that's the right one. Yeah, that'll work. All right, put these up. Take this, which is spring-loaded, put it in here. And the thing is, being because it's spring-loaded, it would never stay in place by itself. So, we apply a slave pin, which sometimes ain't easy to do. We put a slave pin in there to hold it in place. And basically it just holds it in there so when we install everything, it doesn't go flying out. Pretty simple. Okay, let's see here. I don't remember
or if I have to put the trigger in first or the hammer. We'll find out in a minute. Spring came out. Alright, so we're gonna have to do this a little differently. Always use a hammer. Goes in the little slot that it needs to go into. Yep, there we go. See what the issue is now. The spring. See the hand come out right here. That's what's going to revolve our cylinder. So now that thing is in there. This thing goes in there like that. Nugster will like the air bed.
A lot more comfortable than sleeping on the hard floor in here.
Well, she sleeps in her little sleeping bag.
Yeah, but it's on the hard floor.
Bah. It's good for kids to rough it every once in a while.
Should be a tough one.
Bang, bang, bang. Pew, pew, pew. Okay. Put this in here. Thusly. And here's where our slave pin comes in handy. Crap, till it falls out. That was my fault. This is becoming a pain in the butt.
Latex?
What?
Okay, check. But it's been like urgent. I'm gonna get in touch with Jeff.
Yeah,
him.
If it's urgent, I need to know who it's for. Is it, would it be on one of the things?
The little spring has to go in a slot. There we go. And this pin goes in there. Find a sweet spot. My slave pin fell out, so I am lined up at least partly, which is good. I'm just putting it in there a little bit right now. I'm not putting it in there all the way. Put my slave pin over there. Put that a little bit. Alright, now all the parts are working. There's no spring in it, so it's not gonna, no main spring, it's still there. So it's not gonna come back and forth. But I don't need it to for right now. I just need to find out how rough it is as far as going in. Or I need to find out how rough it is as far as turning. Oh, look. I got lucky. Nice. Alright. So we're in business. So I'm going to hammer these in the rest of the way. With the real delicate gun, with a real fine finish, you want to use a punch to finish these off. But this gun is, let's be honest, it's a turd. Take our main spring, which I remember we put it in like this because there is a difference in it. Put our main spring in there. Awesome. Find a little slot. Slot A into tab B. My hands are kind of retarded today, so bear with me. Oh, what the hell? My hands are real retarded today. You gotta be careful on these, they're plastic. Can't over tighten them. Awesome. Set because I had to do some welding. There we go, we fixed it. I'll get ready and test fire.